I want to show you how to create eye-catching graphics and infographic elements similar to those found on Visual Resume. Here is what we will learn to build today. Once you learn the basic techniques, the possibilities are endless. First, I'm going to pick a shape and change its color by selecting the color tool at the top. Then I'm going to make a copy by selecting the object and dragging while pressing the Option key. I will color the second copy in another color for my resume. Now I will stack the two colored shapes on top of each other and go to Arrange menu to specify which one I want to be in front. I will resize the darker shape over my lighter one to indicate skill level. Since I have 5 skills listed, I will make 5 of these visual indicators. Once they're grouped, I will select them all and go to Arrange and distribute evenly. Then I will group and resize it to match my text. Another variation of this design is to have the icons on the left and the text on the right. All you have to do is to ungroup the block and add indent to the left of your text under Text Style and Bullet List. Then modify the block further. Let me show you one more design idea with circles. I'm going to make 5 copies of the shape, 4 in one color and the last one in another, indicating skill level. Then I will make 5 copies and adjust the colors to match my expertise across the categories. Occasionally, when dealing with small section, the automatic indent spacing may not work well. That's precisely why I love tailoring the space or indent amount manually right in the box. Let's do one more resume skill example. This time, create square graphics to indicate language proficiency. First, go to Shapes and select a square. I'm going to change its color under Format, Style, and select a yellow fill. I can manually resize it or go to Format, Arrange, and change the size in inches. If I change the object width right now, I lose my square. So let's undo. In order to keep the square while resizing, I have to check the constrained proportions. I want a small square, so I will make this one 1/2 inch by 1/2 inch. Then I will duplicate it by holding the Option key while selecting and dragging. I will make this square a dark navy and make it much smaller. Then lay it on top of my yellow square. To make sure the two squares are aligned, I will select the center and middle alignment under Arrange. Great, I have my first pair. Now I will group them so it is easy for me to move them around. And then make multiple copies. I'm going to create 4 in a row and group it. And then, again, make 2 more duplicates. Each row represents a different language and my proficiency in it. The dark navy indicates high proficiency. To indicate lower proficiency level, I will change the color of the little square to white. I will do the same for 2 of the little squares in the last row. To get to the style menu for the little square, you don't have to ungroup everything. Just select the little square and click a couple times to drill down the selection to the last group level. After I'm done, I will group them again and reposition under my language skills section. Last thing I have to do is to add my languages. To control the alignment so the text lines up better against my proficiency graphics, I will use the line spacing under Format, Text. When it is final, I will group the 3 sections so I can easily move it about. Up to this point, we have learned all these 3 resume skill infographics indicators. Let's learn how to create one more graphic that I think you will really like. Let's create a progress circle chart, which you can use on a resume or in your keynote presentations. I'm going to go to another slide and add a circle under Shapes. If I try to manually resize the circle, you can see that it is no longer a circle. In order to keep its proportions, I can either press Shift while resizing Or check the constraint proportions box under arrange while resizing. I'm going to change the color of the circle to yellow under format, style, and fill. Then I'm going to make a copy of the circle and change its color to navy blue. And make one more duplicate that will be white. Okay, now I can't see it. So for the time being, I will change my canvas to light gray under format and slight fill. Perfect. The white circle will be the center of our donut hole. I can resize it to make the outer ring wider. I think that looks good. Then place it underneath my percentage amount by selecting to move back under format and arrange. Now we need to cut out a section of our navy circle to represent the progress we want. To do that, I will use another shape, a triangle. You can either eyeball it and estimate it, but I like to be precise, so I created an arc cheat sheet on another slide. I will bring my two shapes there and lay it in the center. The first progress percentage will be easy. Let's do 75%. So I will keep the triangle side at the right angle as it is. Then bring them back to my work area and use the subtract option under arrange to remove the 25% that overlaps my circle. Now I am ready to create my first progress circle chart by layering the different pieces backward or forward with the options in the arrange section. Ta-da! That looks pretty good. Now I'm going to make a copy and this time make it something harder, 60% progress graphic. I will go back to my cheat sheet and select the triangle again. If I want to reshape it to something other than the right triangle that it is, here's a neat trick. Right click on the shape and select Make Editable. Now I can select one of its sides and drag it to the 40% of the circle line. Then select the middle point of the triangle and drag it out to overlap the circle, as we will need to make sure it covers the area that we want subtracted. I will bring a copy back to my work area and use the subtract the modified triangle from my circle. I am left with a perfect 60% progress, which I will combine with my other pieces. That looks amazing, and it was not only easy but fun to make, once you know the tricks. Final piece is to add some progress headings. To add an underline to the heading, go to Format, Text, Layout, and select a line under Paragraph Borders. Then change the offset. Then I will make a copy and reposition for a heading for the second progress graphic. Final thing I want to change is to go back to a white canvas. I made it gray before so that I could see my white middle of the donut graphic. Here are our final infographic elements that you all can now do yourselves. They look pretty neat. Thanks so much for watching.